Welcome, everyone. Rockstar RD call for the number one team in ACN for December 27th, guys. Fired up, excited. People are coming on the call. As you come on the call, just please say your name and how many PBCs you have for the week. Carrie?
Well, three.
Fantastic. Three. Anyone else? Anyone else that hasn't checked in yet? Anyone else that hasn't checked in yet?
13, Mike, for now.
Fantastic. Anyone else? Anyone else that hasn't checked in?
22 PPZs, Mr. Mazur.
Jeff, going into the new year, 22 PBZ. Great job, buddy.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Anyone else that hasn't checked in yet? Guys, welcome to the call. If you could just say your name and how many PBZs you have for the week. We're doing roll call.
Wait, sorry.
11.
How many, Cornell?
11.
Yeah, fantastic. 11, perfect.
I have Lori Shea and I only have three.
Lori, three. Okay, great.
Peter Pasternak,
eight. Hi, Mike.
Peter, eight, perfect. Tina?
I have three. I'm on the road all week, so. Schedule three.
Fantastic. Anyone else?
Kennedy, 18.
Mike Kennedy, how many, buddy?
18.
18. Boom. Big week. Going to be a big week. Moving up the charts. Anyone else?
7.
Who? Oh, and Matt, go ahead.
7.
Perfect. Anyone else? Anyone else that hasn't checked in yet? Anyone else that hasn't checked in yet? We're doing roll call, folks.
Mike, it's Neil. I got four for the week.
Neil, perfect. Got you for four, brother.
Thank you.
Anyone else?
I got four, Mike, and we're working on it.
Four and more coming. Great job. Anyone else?
This is Joel. For time being, I have five, and I'm not sure if Patrick Miller will make it or not. He have six.
Miller six, Joel five. Thank you, Joel. Appreciate it. Anyone else? Anyone else that hasn't checked in yet?
Morning, Mike. I got four.
Dave, got you for four. Back on the East Coast, I see.
Yes, sir.
Fantastic. Anyone else?
Morning, Mike. I've got three.
Dave Barvinia, fantastic. Thank you. Gotcha for three. Anyone else?
Joe Capello for five.
Joe, gotcha for five, buddy. Thank you.
Hey, Mike. Josh Shea, I got seven.
Josh, seven. Perfect. Thanks. Anyone else?
Good morning, Mike. Blessing for
Blessing.
Four.
Gotcha for four. Thank you, Blessing.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Good to see you as well. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Anyone else?
Yeah, Mike, Mark Washam here. I've got nine and go Cowboys.
Nine and go Cowboys. Fantastic. Mark, don't you know that any state that Jeff and Melissa move to, the teams automatically win? You know, you didn't know that?
I love it. I know it now. I believe in it. I'm a believer.
Exactly. Patriots, Cowboys. Anyone else hasn't checked in yet?
Hey, Mike, it's T-Bar.
T-Bar, go ahead.
Got 12, buddy.
12, perfect. Going to be a big week.
Thank you, buddy.
You're welcome. Anyone else? Anyone else that hasn't checked in yet? Hey, guys, are we missing anybody? If you don't see your RD on the call, can you throw them a text and get their PBZs? We want to get a great count for this. Accountability is part of leadership. So anybody else that hasn't checked in yet? Anybody else that hasn't checked in yet? Hey, Harsh, how about Matt Middlestead or?
Yeah, Shayla Smith has 9. Okay, she's at a funeral. Mm-hmm.
Shayla, 9. Anyone else?
Matt's jumping on. He's just wrapping up a phone call.
Okay, perfect. Anybody else we're missing?
Mike Jeffrey's on a corporate call, but he'll be on in a minute.
You know how many PBZs?
He said 3.
Okay, perfect. Anyone else? Anyone? Are we missing anybody?
Everybody. Joe, Giovanni, and Algo.
What's that?
Joe, Giovanni, and Algo.
Nope.
Okay.
Anybody else? Anybody else? All right, guys, let's get the call kicked off for Monday, December 27th, the last week in the year 2021. First of which, I hope everybody had a great Christmas. Merry Christmas to everybody. You know, just excited, guys. This has been a record year for not only the Rockstar team, but a lot of you guys on this call took advantage of everything that happened this year and, you know, really took time and moved your business forward. So I want to say congratulations, but this is the last week of 2021. And, you know, here's what I can tell you, looking over the PBZs, some of you guys are up, some of you guys are down, some of you guys are the same, but let me tell you how important these PBZs are. Everybody that's on these PBZs, everybody, I don't care if they say yes, if they say no, on Friday night at midnight, everybody's going to be making a resolution. And the resolution is going to be one of two things. I'm going to lose weight or what? Make more money. And we can help them do both here. You make a lot of money here and get residual. You can go hire trainers and everything else. But here's my point is it's a very crucial time. Not only that is, you know, it's a lot of people have set a tight time. How many of you agree that this is a light work week for a lot of people? A lot of people taking the weeks on, taking the week off, or maybe a 2 or 3 day work week and, you know, kept cutting out on Thursday and then Friday, Saturday and having a long weekend. So, you know, utilize that because here's what I do know. The people that are scheduling the PBZs, especially the new ones, they're not thinking like a business owner. You know, they're not thinking they're, how many of you have people push it off next year? If you don't have a conversation with them, you're not a coach. And what I mean by that conversation is, look, you can put it off to next year, but here's what I do know. This is the greatest time to build ACN, and here's why. It's a social business. It's a social time. Everybody, if they just jump on and listen for 15 minutes come Friday, they're going to be making a New Year's resolution. And here's what I know about what's going on today. It's hard to go out and find a second form of income. You know, it's not as easy as it was, I get a waitressing job or go pick up this or go pick up that. Those days are a lot harder to find right now. People are looking. They're looking for what we have to offer. So, you know, make sure you're coaching up those PBZs. Make sure you're getting a confirmation list of those PBZs and having that conversation. And, you know, guys, the best weapon in all of our toolboxes is a three-way call. How many of you have done three-way calls before? How many of you said the same thing to the person, you three-wayed in an edified expert, the edified expert said the same thing you said, but because they heard it from somebody else, they did it. So if you're getting pushback, utilize three-way calls. Three-way calls are good for two reasons. Number one is it'll help achieve the goal, whatever that is, getting them qualified, scheduling a PBZ, whatever that looks like. But the second thing it'll do, it'll give you language. See, can you agree when Pat Mazur's words come out of your mouth, his income comes into your bank account, yes or no? That's the key to this business. So just make sure you're on top of your PBZs this week, because here's what I do know. The people that are next year, the beginning of next year, the third, the fourth, the fifth, their business will explode next week based on the fact of what they do today. Now, here's what I'm going to do. Read off the top RVPs. Congratulations, guys. 24 of the top 50 in all of ACN on the Rockstar team. Give yourselves a hand. I mean, guys, we got out of the 32 RDs on this line and RVPs, 24 of you are on the Rockstar, are on ACN's top producing list for team trainer production. Sean Corbett, and Joe Capello. Congratulations, guys. Tied for 34 in ACN. Cornell and Shayla Smith, they're all tied for 34 in ACN. Angel and Flavia Felix, also 34. Rick Thomas, also 34. Raphael Narette, 31. Congratulations. JJ Helm, 31. Congratulations. Matt Barr, 27 in ACN. Harsh Patel and Joel Hulk, tied for 23. Congratulations. Jeff Rincone, 19 in ACN. Lou Brown, 17, tied with Michael Eric, new regional vice president, 17 in ACN. Now here's the top 10. Tom Barr, congratulations, buddy. Number 10 in the team, number 15 in ACN. Number 9, Jovan Dudley. Congratulations, Jovan. Number 9 in the team, 14 in ACN. Number 8, Peter Pasternak. Congratulations. Number 8 on the team, 13 in ACN. Number 7, Sanjita Patel. Congratulations. Number 7 on the team, number 10 in ACN. Number 6 is Matt Mittelstadt. Number 6 on the team, number 8 in ACN. Number 5, Alejandra Kalman. Number 5 on the team, number 7 in ACN. Number 4, Michael Kennedy. Number 4 on the team, number 6 in ACN. Number 3, Mark Washam. Number 3 on the team, number 5 in ACN. Mr. Lance Taylor is number 2, number 3 in ACN, and number 1, Monica Bernardino. Let's give Monica a hand. Congratulations, Monica. 1 on the team, number 2 in ACN. And guys, they're the people that are out there building distribution. They're the people that are, you know, bringing new people into their, you know, here's what I do know. The person that has the most reps is going to naturally have the most customers. Now, want to highlight the individual. See, that's yesterday. Let's talk about tomorrow. Let's talk about this week. Let's talk about the individuals that are going to have a great week. Now, why do I know they're going to have a great week? Because they just got more PVZ scheduled. They have an unfair advantage. They're going to have more people looking at their business, and they're going to have more reps and more customers coming in. And the first person I'd like to bring up has 13 PBZ. She's currently the number 1 regional director on the Rockstar team, number 2 in ACN, and that's Monica Bernardino. So congratulations, Monica, 13 PBZs. Man, you're not letting up the gas between Christmas and New Year's. You're taking advantage of this. And, you know, Monica, for everybody that's listening, you know, who's scheduling those PBZs in your team? Who's coaching them up? Who's getting the confirmation calls, or who's getting the confirmation list calls all yours?
Hey, Mike, obviously. Oh, thank you. First of all, obviously it's a team sport, but we rely on the system so much. So thank you for that. And when you really break it down to what's important, it's scheduling Zooms, making sure that they're coached up right. And number 3, most importantly, is getting that confirmation list. So I am on top of it, every single one of those Zooms. Like the ETLs are literally, they're coming on to close. The reason being is that they'll take excuses. So I am scheduling every single Zoom, coaching every single Zoom. I make sure that's done. And then absolutely 100%, I get that confirmation list. Like I get I don't care if it's one person. I text the person, call the person. I make sure, because I've been able to actually get a couple people who couldn't make it because of the holidays to come to, I met them on a one-on-one, and one of them I signed up. So we're in control of what's going on with the people that these people are bringing forward, which is the basis of our business. So it's all me right now. So
congratulations, you know, but you know, Monica had, how many of you remember the end of the call on Friday where I read off the top people, like the rock stars on the move, the ones that had the most at a PBZ this week and sponsored the most? Out of the 5 people I read names, Monica had 4 of the names, meaning she had 4 people that put more than 10 people on a Zoom, that sponsored more than 4 people at each one of those Zooms. So how many of you see that just taking the time to coach and taking the time to do that confirmation list is going to get you more than just 1 IBO per meeting? So congratulations, Monica, number 1 on the team, 13. I know you're going to put more than 13 IBOs in this week because you're just out there following the system. So congratulations. Next, you're welcome. Next is, where's Mr. Mike Kennedy, 18 Zooms. This guy's climbing the charts, 4 in the team, number 6 in ACN. He's not happy with that. Mr. Mike Kennedy, first of all, I want to say congratulations. And, you know, same question, Mike, who's scheduling the Zooms in the team? who's coaching them up, who's doing the confirmation list, who's getting the confirmation list. Mike, Zoom's all yours.
Yeah, thank you, Mike. And, you know, just kind of, you know, what you guys are saying, you know, the system, you know, we schedule the Zooms. Well, we bring them in, we sign them up, and we schedule their Zooms right away. You know, we coach them up, we get the confirmation list, and we rinse and repeat, you know. And a lot of that is just, you know, being – don't wait, you know, you got that 24 to 48 hours and you got to just, while they're hot and ready, right? Little Caesars, hot and ready. So you got to get it in, you know, get the Zoom in and keep them going, you know, get them paid as fast as you can. And you're going to get more Zooms. We signed up 3 people Sunday and instantly, you know, we're booking Zooms and I got 8 Zooms out of them. So that was, you know, just because I right then and there, hey, let's get your business open. You know, we're not going to sell no burgers if we don't put the open sign on, right? So basically, follow the system, guys. Thank you. Back to you, Mike.
Congratulations, buddy. Following the system is going to get you where you want to go quicker. And, you know, how many of you caught that you got to get them a win quick? Like, how many of you, take a minute to think about this a second. How many of you sign someone up in the business, and this goes for everybody on this line, and you bought their excuse of why they couldn't do something quickly, a week passed, 2 weeks passed, and you couldn't get a hold of them? How many of you have those people in your business? Couldn't even get them qualified. Look, here's what I do know, and I believe this. My mentor told me this. He said, Mike, if you can get them a check in their first 2 weeks of business, they'll stay with you for 4 to 6 months without making another dime. Think about that. They'll stay with you for four. You got to get them a check. How many of you have people come in and going out of your business? I bet you if you went back and tracked it, they're not getting checked because we're buying their excuses. We got to get them moving. Everybody can put a few people on a Zoom, especially if you coach them upright. So Mike, taking control of your business, scheduling up the Zooms, doing the coaching call, getting the confirmation list. You're leaving nothing for chance, but that's why you're number 4 in the team, number 6 in ACN, and you're moving up the charts with 18 PBZs this week. Congratulations. And number 1, Mr. Jeff Rinko, number 19 in ACN. Jeff Rinkin also has the number 31 RD in his team, Raphael. So, Jeff, you know, first of all, congratulations, 22 Zooms. You know, same question, Mike, Jeff. Who's coaching them up? Who's scheduling them up? And who's getting the confirmation list for those Zooms? Call's all yours.
So thank you so much. We just work in the system and just, you know, kind of head down. So we schedule the PBZs. We do it Friday night leadership. No excuses. We do it every week. Then we have the confirmation calls. And we also do the 72-hour call, which is 3 days before. So we actually invite with a new reps, especially. So we focus on that. And then we're focusing on heating up the bottom. So that's kind of where we've been spending a lot of time on. So that's actually created multiple leaders that are trying to break RD. So they're running hard. So and then we ourselves are trying to go RD again so we can break this RVP thing. And we have other people doing it. So it's not all everybody's just duplicating. And then in there, throwing that 100 squares, that's like actually the other part that to it that we've been kind of, it's taking the, like a lot of people want to invite so they can compete. So it's not even like, they don't want to sit there and report, no, I ain't getting no one in front of the business. So they're trying to get people in front of the business. So it's taking a lot of the nervousness for, especially the people that have been around for a second while we work with the new people. So it's kind of, we have like this following the system, and then every 2 weeks, well, twice a week, we have Mr. Mazur, Patrick Mazur, your brother, actually working with us as well, and kind of fine tuning the things that we're missing. So it's kind of having all of that together. We're looking for you ferocious. Excuse me, ferocious. That was your word, 2022. So that's exactly excited about that.
Love it, ferocious. 22 Zooms this week, all over your business. Congratulations. I know you're going to be moving up the charts. Not only are you going to finish big for this week and this month, but you're going to have a great kickoff to 2022. Why? Because you're starting the week before. So congratulations, Jeffrey. And, you know, congratulations to everybody moving your PBZs forward. And, you know, before I talk about qualification, I want to give everybody a gauge on where their business is and where their business isn't. I had a conversation with an RD last week, and they didn't know this. And I'm thinking, man, if they don't know this, I probably haven't said it in a while or haven't let, I want everybody, how many of you want to know where your business is reality-wise? And here's what I mean is, when Pat and I came up with the system, We never counted third or fourth PBZs. Let me say that again. We never counted third or fourth because here's what we realized. Usually about the second PBZ, can we agree, people are pretty much through a big chunk of their list, yes or no? So what happened was, is the third or fourth PBZ never really yielded that one IBO. So how many of you are counting third, first and second PBZs, and how many of you have third and fourth PBZs on the list? If you have third and fourth PBZs on the list, take it. And I'm not saying don't do the PBZ. I'm saying don't count it in the system. So if you have 10 PBZs this week and four of them are the third PBZ or the fourth PBZ or the fifth PBZs, you got to take those four off the top. You really only have six PBZs. You know, so when we would do it on Friday nights, come in, we would only count the first and second PBZ because we realized that the first and second are their best chance. And after that, they're usually through most of their list. Now there's an exception to the rule, but not mostly. So guys, when you're looking at your PBZs, only count your first and the second. And moving forward, you know, we're only gonna count first and second PBZs on this call. So we all get a real gauge of where we are. See, one thing is to do the system and I'm doing what I'm supposed to do, but I'm not getting the results. Well, then there must be a problem in the system. No, it's just how we're calculating or counting the PBZ. So with that being said, guys, qualifications. November 24th, write that down. November 24th is the today they have to be qualified. You have anybody that started November 24th? Today by 5 o'clock, the customers have get in for ACN to pay out that cab to that new IBO and upline. So make sure that you're on top. 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th this week. If your qualifications aren't where they want it to be, pick up the phone. It's really simple. Pick up the phone and don't get off the phone until they get qualified. You know, I tell people all the time, look, I can't get off this phone till we get to your first promotion. So let's just start doing that. So with that being said, I want to highlight the top qualifiers. Rick Thomas, 66% of his team's qualified. Great, Rick. JJ Helm, 66, Michael Eric, 66, and Patrick Miller, 75%. Now, Cornell, great job, Cornell, 100% qualification, brother, getting everybody paid. Alicia Chi, 100% qualification. David Oliveris, 100%. Poppy Massey, 100%. Sean Corbett, 100%. Barvenia Wooten, great job, Barvenia, 100% qualified. And Lance Taylor, 100% qualified. And I'd also like to recognize the greatest. These are the greatest qualification improvements over the last 2 weeks. Tom Barr, great job, buddy. I know you're putting focus on qualification. Congratulations. Great improvement on qualifications. Also, Joel Holk, congratulations, Joel. Great improvement on qualifications. I know you're taking the time. I know you're picking up the phone. I know you're doing whatever it takes to get people qualified. Also, Monica Bernardino, great job, Monica. You know, Monica's always been just great at putting reps in, but the one thing she was missing was getting that qualification. And now it's going with the reps. It's number one on the team. Congratulations, Monica. Great improvement on your team for qualification. And also Jeff and Melissa Street. You know, as an RVP, these guys are, their team is just great qualifiers. And I know it's these guys, they're, you know, running their kickoff parties, doing whatever it takes. You know, Jeff and Melissa will do whatever it takes, and they're doing it, and they're getting their people paid. So I want to say congratulations to those four individuals, just improving and continuing to improve. So with that being said, guys, it's going to be an exciting call. I can't wait to, you know, hear this promotion. But with that, I'm going to get myself out of the way and bring up an individual. He's going to be doing a special training this Friday night for goal setting. You know, here's what I do know about goal setting. Goal setting changed my life. I wouldn't be where I am today without setting goals, without writing it down. You know, he's going to come on and do that for us. I think it's the great time of year to do that. You know, some people, I didn't know how to set goals till I got involved with ACN. How many of you can relate to that? Heck, I didn't set goals before I got involved in ACN. So with that being said, Pat, appreciate you, everything you do and continue to do. This is the number one team in all of ACN. We're really the number one team in this industry going to billions. And with that being said, Pat, Zoom's all yours.
Great to be on here, and Merry Christmas. Hope everybody had a great time with family and friends. And, you know, now it's back to building empires and legacies and creating wealth for your family financially. And I want to thank Michael for, you know, continuing to lead and, you know, pour into us as he does week to week. Matter of fact, this upcoming Wednesday, we're going to do an OIBO call. That's going to be on the 29th. So if you're taking notes, just write that down. This is going to be ran with Harsh Patel, COC, RVP. And what we're looking for is any testimonials. You guys did such a great job of testimonials from the last event. We had a number of people that did just an incredible heartfelt look. Here's the way I felt coming out of that event. We really want to start to focus on, you know, getting your six legs to this event, you know, really, you know, creating that 2022 RVP, SVP, you know, position based on using the live event that we're going to be doing in Dallas, Texas on the 29th. So that OIBO call, you'll get a text, you'll get an email, but it's also you personally promoting it, because look, how many of us want more people joining us in Dallas? How many of us want more people sitting next to you and game planning for 2022 and using the new year and using that renewed mindset? I mean, I'm sure all of us have heard in the last 10 days, hey, first of the year. How many of us heard that from people we talked to? I'm always like, look, I'm not going to call you first of the year, but I will call you the last day of the year. Does that make sense? And I just tell them, I go, look, I'm crushed first of the year. You and a million other people want to do things the first day. I'm not going to be able to talk to you probably until the 15th. But if I call you the last day of the year, I can get you in, take advantage of the bonus, make sure you're positioned to get the 925 that ACN has on for the month of December. But anyway, the call that's going to be on the 29th is really going to be designed to get people to commit up to going to the 29th Emerge event. That's going to be the first live event in 2022. So we want to make sure that everybody's pushing, getting tickets. We know it's going to be a sold out event. We really want to create as many success stories as we can coming out of that event. Also, we're also going to be doing the system training on Thursday. How many of you are getting a lot out of people being on the same page when it comes to the system? How many of you are seeing, you know, the language changing in your team and people saying things like confirmation list or coaching calls? You know, this is going to be something that you're going to see that's going to allow for us to scale. You know, we believe the last 2 years has been in preparation for this year. First year, we had to get our feet underneath us with Zoom. Second year, it's like, okay, everybody has confidence. They can sign people up on Zoom. We're starting to duplicate. Year three is going to be the year of explosion. This is going to be the year of scale. So now we want to really get everybody on the same page as far as having those conversations of coaching calls, having those conversations of confirmation lists. You know, I had here's my experience. How many of us would agree that if they follow that system, they're going to be successful? And I think we've taken probably the last 2 years and we've taken the easy route in a lot of things, just because it's easy to do a Zoom meeting. It's easy to click a mouse. It's easy to get on a Zoom, but making it easy doesn't make it better. Meaning, you know, we used to be fanatical about making sure somebody knew the inviting script, practiced with them, three-wayed somebody else in with them, had them do the inviting script, wouldn't even show up to somebody's house without a confirmation list. You know, we want to really start to bring people back to that system, and it's going to take all of us on here together. And what I mean by that is all of us being on the same page when it comes to the system, meaning are you truly selling your people out to doing it the right way, scheduling Zoom meetings, booking that coaching call, getting the confirmation list. If we can check those boxes moving into 2022, it's going to be an explosive year for all of you. And that's really the goal of this year coming, is getting all of you onto that RVP call. And I don't believe there's any of you here today that can't be an RVP in the next 12 months. But what it's going to take is it's going to take you to be sold out to doing it the right way. Meaning no more cutting corners, no more just haphazardly, no more let's just throw it against the wall and hope it sticks. We've got to have a system that everybody together is following. So this Thursday, look, there's going to be an opportunity for people to learn what that system looks like. The more people that learn what the system looks like, the more accountability within your team. How many of us would agree with that statement? How many of us would love to have ETL saying things like, they don't have a confirmation list, let's get on the phone, or they don't know the script that well, or you know what I mean? They're not doing it the way we told them on how to do it. If everybody's saying the same thing, the buy-in becomes incredibly high. If everybody's saying something different, there's never going to be a buy-in. So we really want to get that buy-in for 2022. And I believe Thursday is going to give us a chance to really give people that opportunity to learn a system, to buy into the system, and then having your business grow because everybody's doing and saying the same thing. That's what makes systems great. Is McDonald's has proven everybody's saying and doing the same things. Dunkin' Donuts, everybody's doing and saying the same thing. We want to have that same culture within the team, but it starts on this call. How many of us would agree with that? It starts on this call. I mean, you're the leaders. Everything down from you, whether it's good or bad, came from you, right? If you have a great culture of people getting qualified, guess what? It came from you. If you have a culture of people not getting qualified, it came from you. If you have a culture of people scheduling meetings, it came from you. If you have a culture of people not scheduling meetings, it came from you. You are creating culture in your team. Whether you like it or not, that's what you're getting. So we want to really make sure that all of us using this next couple of days to do a couple of things. One, people have a relaxed schedule. I mean, period. People, look, I can't take the old I'm shopping excuse anymore. Can we agree with it? It's the 27th. Who are you shopping for? So now we don't have to worry about those sort of things anymore, but we want to lean in on the system and we want to start this Thursday. And we want to make sure that everybody has that same mindset. Second request is, you know, let's make sure that we promote it. You guys did such a great job the last 2 weeks, but because it was something you promoted. And here's why you want to promote it: to make your life easier. How many of us want to go faster and have more people rowing in the same direction? You know, here's what my experience has been. There's two types of people on your team: people that are rowing the boat and people that are drilling holes in the boat. How many of you have some hole drillers, right? How many of you have some people that are literally doing the opposite of what you say? Well, because they're not on the system. They're not on the same page. Look, we know they've got to hear things multiple times. That's why I love the fact that this is the third week that we're teaching the system, because now you're going to get more buy-in because of more people all hearing the same thing. Now, remember, what's our job? Our job is to get excited about the same thing. Does that make sense? How many of you realize, like, your job is to get excited about doing the same thing, but I'm more excited going into a Zoom meeting with a confirmation list. How about you? I'm more excited going into a Zoom meeting with somebody in expectation to have people sign up because they gave you 20 people on a list. Now, how many of you noticed at the end of the call last week, Mike was talking about rock stars on the move, people that have put big Zoom meetings together. So make sure as you go through your week, anybody that does a big Zoom meeting, just let Mike know who they are so we can give them some recognition on Thursday night leadership this week. Like, I want to recognize people that have done 20 people on a Zoom event, 17 people on a Zoom event, because if we can create that culture, how many of us agree there's going to be people that will be sitting on that Zoom on Thursday saying, man, I could put 20 on a Zoom. They should be calling my name. And the more people we have saying those things, the more times you're going to have an opportunity to get in front of more people, because we're creating a culture of people having big Zoom meetings. So that's really the goal moving into 2022 is, number one, help you go faster. How many of us here want more help going faster, right? No, number two is having everybody feeling that this is the exact, if they're not doing it the right way, then they know, look, I'm not doing it the right way. I bought a McDonald's, I'm selling tacos. You told me to sell burgers. I didn't sell burgers. Now it's not your fault, it's their fault. Because they know that they know. And then also having an opportunity to, you know, bring people to this upcoming event on the 29th, that we know is going to be just an incredible opportunity to kick the gear off and really get people in the mindset of success, what we were looking for people to do. So number one, congratulations, Monica, great job this week. Also, Mike Kennedy, great job with 17 plus Zoom meetings. And then also Jeff Rincone with 22, you know, just shows me they're doing what's necessary to help their team grow. They're booking Zoom meetings. They're doing the things that all of us here know is important for success. And, you know, with that, I would like to turn it over to Harsh. We got a really a special call here today. You know, we're so excited about what you're going to get a chance to witness, and, you know, looking forward to having multiple people have the same thing happen here in the next handful of weeks. So Harsh, thank you for what you do. Thank you for jumping in on the 29th, this upcoming Wednesday. Harsh is going to be leading that call and helping us to really create vision for the upcoming live event that ACN's doing in January. So with that, I want to turn it over to you, Harsh.
Well, Patrick, thank you for all you do and for this team and being here. I know you don't have to be here on Monday mornings, but you just want to help every single one of us. You and Mike just want to help every single one of us become very, very successful with the system you guys created. And what being said with the system, guys, the system's creating results. I mean, we can agree documentation beats conversation. And the gentleman about to promote, literally, you know, when I met him a few handful of years ago, it was actually in a meeting we did. And, you know, you never know when you meet somebody. I still remember till today, this guy was literally crying, I should say, was literally crying, was begging, looking for an opportunity, wanted a way out. I remember having his Matrix truck out there and he's, man, I need something. And, you know, this guy plugged into a simple system. I had to pretty much tell him, listen, show up to Saturday training. If you don't like what you see, I'll pay your gas money. Like that's what it took for me to get this guy to a training. And literally came out and then he gave me the excuses of I don't fly. I said, listen, it's your birthday. You're coming to the Nationals. So we'll celebrate your birthday there. It's a story. So, you know, the good thing is you just got to fight for people and literally fought for this guy. And, you know, he used to go to Jeff Melissa's training in Connecticut. I mean, this guy literally drove 2 hours. I mean, there's stories behind this guy's success, seeing a transformation from what he was 2 years ago till today. I mean, just last year, I remember him talking about us before May of last year. He only had 40 something or 50 something customers, and today over 4,500 customers in just a year and a half. You know, the transformation what this guy went to, just, you know, going through what he's going through, promoting 3RDs. I mean, if you know him, we call him Mr. Excitement. You know, this, it's surreal to even, you know, just think that he's a regional vice president, because, you know, if this guy hits home, man, this guy literally hits home. I mean, me and him, he moved to Texas, moved to Florida. I mean, this guy's done it all. Things that we shouldn't be doing, was always thinking. I mean, almost got arrested too, if you think about it. It's kind of funny. He always putting call me now on ATM machines and almost got pulled over by a cop. I mean, this guy's tried everything. And when we literally said, just follow the system, that's what's here today, you will get results. And literally followed a simple system, did PBZs, which became super, super coachable, never missed a Friday night leadership, never missed an Emerge event, never missed anything. And today we get to celebrate him as a regional vice president. And I literally called him that day when he promoted. I'm like, man, you're regional vice president. Congratulations. He goes, Harsh, congratulate me when I'm COC. So I know what his eyes are set on next year and what he's about to go do. So, Michael, congratulations, my man, regional vice president. You're an official regional vice president on the call here today. So congratulations, man. Just want to promote you here, buddy. Congratulations, bro.
In the club, party rock, looking for the girl, she on my jock, huh? Now stop. Guys, I'm fired up to be here.
Turn it off.
Yeah, just fired up to be here. Hang on. Come on, turn that off. Okay. Yeah, guys, just fired up to be here. Obviously, my mom just got here. So, guys, I'm fired up to be here. Just I can't even picture like what's happening here. Like, just amazing things, right? So, you know, my little journey, I just want to get back to my journey real quick. You know, my journey is not has been nothing more than just, you know, I just wanted it hard. I wanted it. And I joined ACN for a reason. I saw there was an opportunity that I can make some money part-time with real estate. And I met Harsh for the first time out in Wappinger Falls, New York, at my real estate broker's office. And he showed me a business that I got excited. Now, when I didn't get excited when this guy pulled up in the kitchen table and I was going to meet Joe, my regional director, and not Harsh, but this guy pulled up and I said, who are you? And he goes, my name's Harsh Patel. And I was like, okay. You know what I mean? So it's nice to meet you. And he showed me a business and I literally was crying.
the day I signed up. Like, he's like, listen, just join. I'll show you. I needed to change. I was looking for something. And then I was crying. It's I'm not going to sit here and, you know, and just tell you the true story, you know? And then from there, I joined because I was looking for a change. And then I started working, and then I wasn't going to go to training. I didn't go to training for like maybe 3-4 months. I didn't do anything really in 3-4 months. And Harsh called me and said, hey, listen, are you going to go to training on Saturday? I said, no, I'm good, man. I got to rake the leaves. I got to paint the mailbox. I got to take care of the house. I'm single. I want to go out and have some fun. So, you know, and he said, I'll pay for the gas. I said, you'll pay for the gas? And he said, yeah. I said, okay, I'll go. Now, this was down in Queens with the MD Ramen and the Cornell Golds and all those, right? So I drove way down to Queens, took my plow off the truck, drove there, and did what I had to do. Parking was a nightmare. You know, everything about Queens is a nightmare when you live in the country, right? So I went down there and I went to training. And that's where, you know, I listened and I was like, wow, this is cool, but I got to go. And at the end of the meeting, you know, they made everybody that was going to the convention get on stage. And then the people are sitting there, you know, they talked to and they said, you know, what are you, you're not going to the convention? I said, no, I said, I don't fly. It's my birthday. You know, I want to have some fun and I'm going to do it right here in this hometown. And he's like, well, how about if I help you out with some of the hotel? And I said, okay. I said, then maybe I might think about it. Get on stage. So I got on stage. And when I went to Phoenix, guys, I really opened my eyes. I was just like, oh my God, 25,000 people sitting here. The way I was treated, it was just unbelievable. You know what I mean? And then I went through some hard times and I was building. And then it's like everything else in life, we all go through a breakup. So my girlfriend for the first time broke up, we moved to Florida and I let it go. And then I started building ACN at a higher level and I was excited. And I had like 300 customers and maybe, I don't know, 30, 40 business partners. And I moved to Florida, thought I can do it in Florida. Well, it didn't work out in Florida too well. As you don't know, there's no energy. You know, it's a tough state to do it in. So, you know, before COVID, now after COVID, you could do it anywhere because you just talk to someone in an energy state, you know? And so I decided to pack my bags. I went to Dallas, Texas, and I started working with Harsh at a higher level, working with Mike Mazur. I mean, I'll never forget going to my first PBZ with Mike and Harsh, and I was so excited. You know, I was learning and growing and found out some bad news, and you know, I had to move on. So I had to pack my stuff after 6 months, move back to Florida, drop her off, and leave my dog behind, my girlfriend behind, and drive up north, okay, to New York. I hid in Florida for like 3 months. I was like, you know what, I don't even want to deal with life. And my mother walked in the door. She says, guess what today is? I said, what's today? She goes, moving day. You're out of here, okay? You need to go and you need to get out of here and grow. So I went back home, dealt with all the problems I had, and just really focused. And I was playing with ACN a little bit there. And then Mike Pat actually said to me on an end of the year call, I said, what do you want out of ACN? He said, I need you to go to training. And I said, but you want me to drive to Connecticut, which is 2 hours away. And you want me to go to training in New York City for 2 hours away. I said, if it's all day on Saturday, all day, I get on a train at 6 o'clock in the morning. I go down to the Queens. I get into Manhattan at like 10 o'clock. I do the training. I get back on the train at 1:00. And then I take a 2-hour train back up north and I won't get home till like 5 o'clock back. And he said, Mike, there's people that take that train for 40 years and never retire. Words sunk right into me. And I was just like, wow. I said, yeah, okay. So I said, you know what? I guess I need training. Yeah, you need training because you ain't going anywhere with what you got. So you got training. So, you know, or go see Jeff and Melissa. So I decided to go to New York City and I, you know, went down there, started learning, started growing. They were always nice to me down there training and I was coming from far away. And then I got addicted. Like I was just like every Saturday I'm up because this is what I said, my bank account, my friends, my family, nobody was supporting me, nobody. And I was just like, you know what? The only person who was supporting me was my mother. You know what I mean? And, you know, and so I just decided that I said, you know, we were going down to training and everything was great. Everything was perfect. I was learning. I was growing. I even had a team growing in Connecticut. Now I'm going to Tuesday training with Melissa and Jeff, and I'm going to training down in the city. Now I got two teams going both places, and then COVID hits. And we all know what happened there. And, you know, we all went into a standstill and I wasn't selling real estate and real estate wasn't really moving. And I started to get a little scared. You know, it reminded me of the day after they played that movie in high school for me. You know what I mean? And with the gas stuff. And so I was just like, okay, I really need to look at this. And then I got a check in the mail that I never respected. And Harsh used to say this all the time. You want to save your money for you never know we're going to go through another recession. I go, another recession. That, I'm not even going to be alive at that time. So I'm not even worried about that. You know what I mean? And then when that happened, I really thought about it. I was like, wow, you know what? That day is happening right here. Like we got no, I can't sell real estate. New York was shut down. We weren't allowed to sell real estate at all. And I said, you know what? I started to like, you know, go into freak zone. And then I went ahead and got a phone call from Mike. Mike called me and said, hey, Mike, you know, hey, man, how's everything going? You know, Senior Vice President Mike Mazur, you know, I have on my phone, Senior Vice President Mike Mazur, answer the phone. That's what I have on his name. Okay. Because when he calls you, you take the call. Okay. With a special ring. And I hope you have a special ring for him too. Okay. Because that's a privilege for him to call you. So he called me and I was talking to him and he went into, hey, why don't you come out to Dallas and spend some time with me? And I said, I can't go. My mom, you know, I got to worry about my mom. I got to worry about the house. I got to worry about everything. And I'm not even selling real estate. I'm living off a bank account now. And I think the world's going to come to an end and da, 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 da. And he goes, I'm going to ask you again, man. Why don't you just come out and spend some time with me? And I was like, no, I'm good, man. I'm good. And he's like, all right, no problem, man. I just wanted to reach out to you, you know, and that was that. Well, 2 days later, I get a phone call from Regional Vice President Harsh Patel, and it wasn't a friendly phone call. Let's just say that. And it was, wait a minute. Did Mike call you today or the other day? I said, yeah, he did. I said, what did he say? He said, he asked me to come out to Dallas, but I can't because, you know, I got things going on, da, 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 all these excuses. And he goes, Mike, how many times did Mike fly to New York? How many times was he in your living room? How many times did he risk his life in a tin can to come out and leave his family behind to come help you build your business? And you can't get on a plane and go see him at his house? There's people that dream about that, that would love to have that happen. And you're telling him no? I'm like, yeah, I told him no. I said, you know what, Mike? This is the end right here. This is where we have to part ways because I can't have this happen. I was like, whoa, 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 whoa. Hang on for a second. What do I got to do? What do I got to do? How can I fix this? I don't know. I got to think about this. You know what you can do? Get on a damn plane and go out to Texas. I said, what time are you going to go? He says, I don't know. Don't ask 1,000 questions. Just go. Just get out there. So, you know, I called him up. I said, okay. I said, I'm buying a ticket now. So when am I going to come home? He goes, Mike, stop asking 1,000 questions. You're just going to go to Dallas and we'll figure out the rest there. You need Dallas. And back then, guys, I only had 40 customers and 600 customers. I just became an RD in April and 40 business partners. Okay. Not knowing what I was doing, putting in an app in a month. And then, you know, I learned a lot from Mike just watching, and Mike's smart. You know, he waits for the right time to talk to you about certain things. And some of them are not easy to talk to. And, you know, I just remember one instance where I was working with a bunch of ETLs and I was growing a team. And he says, that Monica comes in the room. She goes, what is that? I said, oh, I'm doing an ETL helper call, an RD helper call, like get you to go to RD. And she looked at the call. She goes, does Mike know about that? I said, no, don't tell him because I just want it. Whoa, 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 whoa. Wait a minute. Michael. And he came down and he looked at the computer and he saw people on the computer and he goes, turn that thing off. I said, no. He said, turn that off. You know, so just the stuff that he taught me, you know, just powerful stuff, guys. And I was ready. Like the teacher will arrive when a student appears. And I was a student at that time. I was ready. I was looking. I was scared the world was going to come to an end. And Mike always kept saying, Mike, this will pass. And when it passes, you're going to be on top. You're going to be on top because you're going to have the information. You know, so I learned, I grew. I just never forget one thing. We were out to dinner and Franco LaFranco saw me. He goes, Michael Eric. And I'm like, the guy knows my name. Like, I couldn't even believe he knew my name, you know? And I was talking to him on FaceTime, you know, Franco LaFranco. So, but when I came home, I just decided, I said, you know what? I landed the plane. I said, you know what? This is my turn. This is my time. You know, I put a lot of mistakes just like everybody else. You know, I've been here for a while. You know, I only got one more shot at it. You know what I mean? And then I was 50, right? 51, but now I'm 53. So, you know, 55, 60 is coming around the corner and it just makes sense. A $200 business, grow a business. And I just decided, I said, you know what? I made a decision. I just said, you know, I made a decision that I had to do this. There's no questions about it. Like, I don't really care what you said, what you're going, what you're doing, how you're doing it. I don't care. I just know that after I've been there for 3 weeks, I was never treated like that. You know what I mean? Just giving me just the information and learning and growing. And some of it wasn't easy, guys. I was sitting in a room and they're doing their thing and I'm in the room. How many you got? How many you got? Like, just stretching me like a rubber band. And you know what I mean? Like, just, you know, and because I wanted it, you know, I wanted it and I was asking for it. So I just went home and went to work. And then I just figured out Zoom. I went out and bought a camera because I wanted to look professional. I wanted my picture to look better. I don't want some stupid looking picture on, you know, that you can get your from computer. Why? I mean, listen, I used to spend money on gas. I used to spend money on tires. I used to spend money on traffic. I used to spend money on, you know, going to Connecticut was just 2 hours, and traffic in Danbury, that's another hour. So Danbury, Connecticut. So, you know, I was okay with buying a $20 camera. I was okay with buying a $20 microphone that it makes me sound better. And I was okay with buying a brand new TV that I'm going to stare at because the 16-inch TV screen, you know, the from the laptop that switches over to the thing, because I'm going to look at this thing all day. I want to, you know, be able to, you know, have fun at it. And I just decided that I was going to go to work. And then all of a sudden I started working and I ran into, I started taprooting, going down. And then I was working with Joe Capello, regional director now, and put meetings on. He got excited. He got excited. He started doing it. And I started to feel better. I started, wow, this is actually working. And then all of a sudden, Javon, regional director Javon Dudley, was doing the business, but he had some things going on in his life. He called me up. He said, hey, man, who's this guy, Joe Capello? I said, and then he saw Joe. And then those two, I put those two together. I call myself the connector. I put those two together. They started talking. Now I got Javon running. Now he's a regional director. You know, that's how that all happened there. And then I went and made a phone call to, you know, I made a lot of phone calls, not just one, a lot of phone calls. And a lot of phone calls that said no, hung up the phone on me, everything else. But there was one phone call that I called the realtor, and she gave me about 15, 20 people. And that's how I found Al. And the guys, the funny thing is, I didn't even do the meeting for Al. Al signed up on my team. I woke up the next morning with Al on my team, and I didn't even know who he was. And Javon and Joe did the meeting because I was doing another PBC in Rochester, New York. Really, Poughkeepsie, New York, but Rochester because I was in Rochester. So, you know, it's all about just, you know, you got to have passion. You have to lead by example. You have to be know more than what the people know. Like, you have to come in with passion. You have to come. See, the secret is, guys, is I listen to Jordan Belfort, and we all know who he is, Wolf of Wall Street. And I listen to him every day. Okay. Yeah, I don't really care what you think about him. I just know that he's enthusiastic. He's sharp as a tack, and he knows what he's talking about. Okay. And you have to be fired up. Okay. And the reason why is because he sat in jail wondering if he ever was going to see his daughter again. And the only thing that kept him alive, because he wanted to commit suicide, was that he decided that he was going to live for his daughter and go out and live for his daughter. So when I heard that, I was like, wow, you know, and I listened to a lot of personal development. Okay. Because Patrick always says, what you do in private, you celebrate in public. You know what I mean? So you got to listen to the books. You got to not just put the books and stare at it and say, yeah, I'm reading the book. No, highlight it, rip the pages out, and intubate, you know what I mean? And really study it. You know, Ed Milet, I listen to Ed Milet. You listen to him sooner or later, you're going to become him. You know what I mean? And Grant Cardone and just a lot of powerful people, you know? And Hearst always makes fun of me because I'm always on the women's when they call. But this is what I figured out. I got a bunch of women on my call that need to know what to do. And I'm not going to coach them because I'm not a woman, right? So I put them on the call. But if I'm going to put them on the call, does it make sense that you be on the call? Chanel Burke called me the other day, said, I see you on the women's call all the time. You're a powerful individual. Like, my phone rang. I didn't even know who it was. And it was Chanel Burke. And she even recognized it. And I don't even show my, like, I show my face, but I don't say one word because I'm not a woman. But if there's 400 people on there, 400 women on a call, don't you think that you might want to plug your team into that? How I look at it is I sit back and let them get coached by the women. And now look what's happened. I got an all women's Airbnb. That was Harsh's idea, not my idea. You know what I mean? He's like, where am I sleeping? I'm not worried about you. I'm worried about your team. You know, so just serve your team. This is what I want you to say, guys. I want you to serve your team like you've never been served before. I want them to walk away and I want them to say, my God, he's really doing so much. Can I do another PBZ right after another PBZ? Yeah, I could do 30 right now because I'm looking for an SVP. Okay. And I hope it's under you. So you got to serve. So they walk away like the wow factor. Like, oh my God, I can't believe what he's doing. I can't believe he has the information. Listen, if they're calling you up and they're asking for information and you don't know the answer, strike one. If they're calling you up again and they're asking, oh, how do you do this? And you go, let me call my upline. Well, why are they calling you? you're a regional director. You know, they'll just call the next person. So you have to serve your team, show up all the time, be consistent. And the last thing is, you know, I was forced to take Landmark. Okay. I wasn't like, it wasn't something that I wanted to do. Spend $600 on a class to go stare at yourself in a mirror. Okay. But one of the best things I ever did, Mike and Pat and Harsh kind of talked to me about it, of course, you know, and I was like, not really. Yeah, I'm not doing that. But then, you know, I decided I wanted to do it, you know, because I took the advice and it really helped me out. Because if you want to be ordinary, just take the ordinary classes. But if you want to be extraordinary and you don't want to be a storyteller and you don't want to just keep, you know, looking in the mirror and realize who you really are, about being authentic and being real and saying something that when you say something, do it. That's something that I got from, you know, and not letting, you know, not letting the past drag you down to the future, because all we have is the future. You're not going that way, because that way it's over. Right. So you want to go that way and you just got to focus on it. So every single person on this call, my entire team, I would not be anywhere in this company if it wasn't for the training that they have, the leadership that we have. You know, when you're getting on the call and you're hearing the number one, like I literally used to go down to Miami to do training with Max Knoll, and people used to say, you work with Pat and Mike? Yeah, why? Oh my God, what's it like? Well, I ain't like your testimonial. I could tell you that much, because your testimony, I could take a nap. Okay. So, certain things that Mike and Pat have that really are the reason why it's there. And you got to know the whole story too. Like everything that they went through, you know, Cartridge World, and then went ahead and went to, you know, got the clothes from a lady out in a mom out in Massachusetts. You got to know the story. Pay attention, take notes, record. Start a YouTube channel. You know why I started the YouTube channel? Because I'm sick and tired of talking. And I want to talk to one person and let them listen to it forever. And I had a whole YouTube link hidden that nobody knew about. I literally went down to the city, MD Ramen was talking, and I would take a whole tripod, put it right in front of MD and record it and have the cord going where people, right? I mean, people in New York City know what I was doing. And I put the cord right over, look out for the cord. It's recording MD Ramen, okay? He's not going to be here forever. I got to get this information. And then I would get it, record it, take it home. And I hid it all. But then when the virus hit and we weren't allowed to go into hotels no more, I called up a guy on Fiverr. I said, make me a YouTube channel. And I want all my stuff on there. You know, so I just, you know, you have to lead by example. You got to want it like nobody ever wanted it. And just go after it. And think about your why. Think about why you're doing this business. What did you sign up for? Did you sign up for the ACN fan club? Or did you sign up to really take your business to the next level and take your life to the next level and take your income to the next level and just grow? And this is just getting excited. I can't even believe I'm here. I just work, and that's all, and just work. And then I know it's all coming together. So, you know, I got a lot to learn at the RVP level. I was just on an RVP call. I was dazed, you know, just to see what's going on behind the scenes. Listen, these guys are hard workers. These guys are putting the time in for you. That's all they're doing. We literally just talked for an hour about every single RD on this call. So I just want to thank everybody. Every single person on here has a major part of my success. I'm not going to be able to do this alone. You know, I am going after Circle of Champions member. It's not a secret. Okay. I am going after, you know, a senior vice president, and I'm nowhere near done. Okay. I'm done when I see SVP in front of my name. So thank you. And hopefully this will serve you well. Thank you.
Congratulations, Michael. Great, great job. Regional vice president. How many of us got a lot out of Michael's speech here? Man, I'll tell you, he said a lot. And, you know, we appreciate that, Michael, and the journey and just the amount of wisdom you picked up along the way. And now, look, implementation. You know what I saw you take all that information. And then once the pandemic hit, it was like preparation meets opportunity. And there you were. And now today you're regional vice president. You know, it's great to be an RVP, isn't it? And you got reps in as an RVP too. Isn't that nice? Welcome to the pay increase, and, you know, congratulations on finishing what you started and now on your way to Circle of Champion member. I took a note on that too as well. So, you know, excited for you, excited for everybody. Look, it's just an exciting time of the year. You know, I truly believe the next handful of days, this is where you're setting your 2022 up to be an amazing year. You know, don't get caught up in the, you know, slow down, get caught up in the speed up, you know, get caught up in using this time to advance your business and advance your, your customers and advance, you know, your life. And with that, Mike, anything else you want to add before we close out the call?
Congratulations, Michael Eric, brother. Proud of you, excited about your future, and, you know, just can't wait to see you here in the near future and celebrate you, bro. Congratulations again.
The 29th, brother. We're going to have a big old celebration for you on the 29th, so get ready. January 29th, we're bringing it all to Dallas, Texas, and, you know, I'm going to send it over to Derek Wilson and just send us off with a prayer here. We got a deep prayer bench here, and Derek's been just a great leader, and I know he's inspired by Michael's speech, and I know he's the next to go RVP. So with that, let me send it over to you, Derek.
Awesome, awesome. Great call today. Michael, Mr. Excitement, Mr. Eric, brother, so proud of you and what you've been able to accomplish. So let's close this with the right mindset as we wrap up 2022. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the opportunities that you presented to us. We realize that it was not us, but it was your grace and mercy that's brought us to this point. We've reached a plateau where we're coming to the end of another year. And many started off this year, and many, unfortunately, are not here today, but you've allowed us to be here. And for that, we are eternally grateful. We thank you for allowing us to see the maturation and the growth for Mr. Eric, Michael, and how he's now come from nowhere to being somewhere, to being someone that people look at as a leader and someone that they want to follow. And you've watched his growth, and because of his belief, because of his energy and his excitement, you saw fit to allow him to accomplish his goal of regional vice president. So we thank you for that feat. We thank you for his work ethic, for his tenacity and his ferocious desire to win. And we realize, looking at Mike, that if we have the right attitude, there's no stopping our altitude in ACN. So as we wrap up 2022, give everyone on this line the courage, the conviction, the desire to step out and step up their efforts to do better, to do more, to become better, to become more, to reach the level of success that we all deserve to have. With you, all things are possible. There is nothing impossible. We serve a mighty God. We thank you for your grace and your mercy. We thank you for our leadership, all of the regional vice presidents on this line, all of the leaders, and especially Michael and Patrick, who've given us the DNA code for what a true servant leader is all about. So as we wrap up this RD call today, I do believe this will be the last one of 2022. We thank you. We thank you so much for allowing us to be here, and we promise that we will do all that we can, each and every one of us, until we have reached 20,000 IBOs a month, 20,000 qualified IBOs a month joining this Rockstar team, where we will impact, we will change lives, and we'll make people's lives more powerful and better for their families. We thank you so much. In your mighty, precious name we pray. Let all of God's children who believe this prayer say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Derek. Thank you, everybody. Amen. Let's see you Thursday night. Let's pack it out. God bless each of you.
20,000 reps a month.
Do it.
I love Michael Eric.